Hi guys, welcome to the world of MongoDB. In today's session, we'll see how to install MongoDB on Linux operating system. We'll cover the following topics. We'll have a small introduction about what is MongoDB, and we'll see how to get the suitable version of MongoDB, and then what are the configuration changes to be done for the operating system for this installation. Then we'll see how to do the MongoDB installation, and we'll also see how to start the MongoDB. MongoDB is a document-oriented database. The guys who are already familiar with RDBMS format of the database, this will be a slightly different. MongoDB aims for storing a large volume of data. It's a part of a big data concept. So MongoDB, we can say in nutshell, we can say it's a highly scalable document-oriented database. It stores the data in the form of documents. For the database RDBMS folks, the document is similar to, or it's an analogy to the rows in the normal relational database management system. And MongoDB stores the data in the form of document and collections. So document, the analogy for the documents is rows, and collections is equivalent to the table. So you can see that a MongoDB database consists of a lot of collections, which is equivalent to tables, which consist of documents, which is nothing but the rows. We'll be having a detailed session on what is a document database, how to create the document database, etc. in one of the following classes in our MongoDB series. This session, we are not aiming to go in depth of a document database. We are concentrating on how to install the MongoDB. So we'll see how to get the suitable version of MongoDB. MongoDB is an open source database. You need not have to have any license for downloading and testing the MongoDB. You can download the latest version of MongoDB from www.mongodb.org. An important point to be noted with respect to the versions. You can see that all the event point releases, like say 3.0.4, so that is an even all the event points, you can see that it is ending with 3.0.4, so that all the event point releases are stable versions, and all the odd point releases like 3.1.5 are of development releases. So you wanted to try, or you wanted to install the MongoDB for your production environment, I would recommend that you always go ahead with the event point releases, that is ending with the digits like 2, 4, etc., so that you are installing the stable version. The latest version as of the preparation of this document is 3.0.4, is the latest stable release. And you can see that the latest stable release is one version lower than the development release. Now we'll see how to configure our operating system for the installation. In the case of Linux, the default directory, the database directory, or the directory at which the database are getting created, is /data/db. So if you wanted to maintain the default location, you must have this directory created. MongoDB expects that the directory is already existing before you start up the installation. And the default listener port, or the default port number through which you can connect to the database, 27017. And also another point is that MongoDB starts a basic HTTP server on the port 1000 port higher than that of the default port number. For example, our default port number for the database is 27017. So the HTTP server, which accepts the database request, will be running on 28017, which is 1000 port higher than that default database port. So if you wanted to install the MongoDB with the default options, you must make sure that the port number 27017 as well as 28017 is free, and as well as you must create a directory /data/db. Now we'll see how to install MongoDB. MongoDB, you must download the suitable version of MongoDB based on your operating system, kernel version of the operating system. You can download from mongodb.org. In this example, we are doing the practices on a 64-bit operating system. So I downloaded the 64-bit MongoDB software, which is a tar software. So I created, then the next step is that you have to create a directory where you want to install. So I created a directory /MongoDB and then copy the files to that location, and then we can untar the software. So once the software is untarred, then we will say that that is a MongoDB installed directory, or in for the normal RDBMS for Fox, you can say that that is a home directory for MongoDB. So if you wanted all the MongoDB commands to be executed without going to the installed directory, you must export the path variable, that is export path equal to $path : MongoDB installed directory /bin. So all the executables are in the bin directory of the MongoDB home directory. So you must provide that path to your path variable, so you can invoke the MongoDB commands from anywhere. So once the MongoDB is installed, then we have to start up the MongoDB. So the MongoDB can be started by running the mongod command, mongod. So if you have set the path variable as explained in the previous section, you can just start the MongoDB from anywhere from the command prompt. Otherwise, you must go to the MongoDB home directory, insert that bin directory, and from there you have to start the MongoDB. So that way it will be like mongo slash, assuming that our MongoDB home directory is /MongoDB, then you have to invoke the mongod command, or you have to start up the MongoDB by giving the command /mongodb/bin/mongod. And if you wanted to have a non-default directory, in that case you must specify the non-default database directory during the startup, like mongod -db path space the path of the db directory. Say for example, I have created /testdb as my db directory. In that case, I'll be giving the command mongod -db path space /testdb. That way I'm starting the MongoDB from a non-default database directory. And once the MongoDB started, it will not return any prompt for you. So if you want to stop the MongoDB, you can just issue the control and letter C together. So control plus C will stop the MongoDB. Hope the theoretical part of this session is clear for you guys. The next session we will be seeing the practical for this session, that we'll do the installation on the Linux operating system. Hope this session is clear for you guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Hope this video was useful for you. If you have any questions on this topic, please send a mail to me. My mail ID is trainer@vaish.com. And please do subscribe to our YouTube channel. The link is given in the bottom of this window. We'll be releasing at least one video every week. And if you have any specific requirement, please send that requirement to trainer@vaish.com. We are happy to work on your requirement, and we'll be posting the video at the earliest. Once again, thanks a lot.